So my name is Michael. I'm part of a band called Nice Guy, based in Middlesbrough and around, well, around the Teesside area, around different parts. We've been going since 2019, early 2019. We've just been sort of steadily gigging and building up a profile and like a few releases and sort of just trying to get a name for ourselves and keep busy, especially at the moment, what with everything that's going on.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll come back to that lockdown issue later on. So, have you always been involved in music? Is that something you did growing up? Do you come from a creative background?
Well, my granddad, they're really good like artists, like they can draw and paint and whatever, yeah, but I've got none of that ability whatsoever. But I've always loved music. I sort of grew up listening to Motown. I grew up like listening to what my mum and dad were playing, and I wanted to be involved in it. I didn't really pick up a guitar and start writing songs until I was about 16. But before that, I used to do poetry in school, which was really, really bad, really bad poetry. So I thought, you know what, I'll put a bit of music to it and see what happens. And then yeah, I was in a band before this called Boycott the Radio, and then which did okay in the Teesside area. And then I was in a band called Mau Coco for a little bit, and then Nice Guy came about, and I've been doing that since.
Great. So how did Nice Guy come about? How did you all meet?
The drummer out of Nice Guy, Matt, he was in Boycott the Radio with me. I met him when I worked in McDonald's at university. And we sort of had a similar love of music and from similar backgrounds as well, like with terms of like family and things like that. So we got on really well. The guitarist in our band is the brother-in-law of Matt now, because he's married his sister. And Chris, I worked with when I worked in Yarm. I worked at a bar, and he was just always talking to me about music. And I was like, do you know what? I'll come along for a jam and then see how it goes. And he did, and it was like a perfect, it just all sort of came together straight away. And then very recently we've had added Patrick Oliver into the band, who plays keys. And he's in loads of different bands around the area. And if you're sort of playing music around Teesside, you'll have likely seen him. And he was just always saying to us, you know, come try out. So we did, we got him in, and it's just been a match made in heaven.
Brilliant. I love it when a plan comes together. Up till now, what kind of venues have you been playing at?
We've been mostly playing around Teesside. So we played the likes of the Georgian Theatre, Q Bar. We played when it was Music Lounge, and we played any volume bar. That was the last gig we did. So we've just done like loads of shows around there, but we've also played in we've played a gig in Hull as well, because I used to live in Hull for a little bit. So that was fun. It was good to see all my old friends and whatever.
Whereabouts is that?
Hull.
I mean, what venue?
It was a social club. I can't remember what it was called, but it was like a social club put on by one of our, because the band that we were supporting were one of my friends' bands. But we played like O'Reilly's in Hull before as well. And we applied to play the Adelphi, but everything got shut down. So
Yeah,
yeah.
that was. I was wondering if it was there. I used to live in Grimsby, so I used to go to Hull, to the Adelphi.
I
So
used, I used, when I lived in Hull, I used to travel to Grimsby because you had a Taco Bell and Hull didn't.
God, I can't imagine anyone travelling into Grimsby. All to do was go elsewhere. Slightly sidetracked there. So, you've just picked up the guitar yourself. That's not something that you've had any like formal instruction. And if so, what was your learning?
Basically, yeah, I just picked up a guitar. I used to dance around with a tennis racket, pretending to play a guitar. So I thought, you know what, just got like, while I was at college and that, you know, you have time where you free time on your hands to learn things. And I started off by learning "Zombie" by the Cranberries, because it's only four chords. And then I was just set away. I've never had any like formal training or anything. It's just when you start playing with other musicians, you really come on. They show you things and you learn things, and then you've got to have a real want to do it, I think. Otherwise, because your fingers don't work at first, you get frustrated. So that's basically how I started out, just sheer perseverance and not really much else to do.
Yep, absolutely. That's great to me. It's like mutual learning and support. So lockdown, I suppose we've got to cover that. So obviously you've been out, you've been playing quite a few gigs, you're trying to build your name, and then lockdown happens. Have you been able to work together at all? Have you been able to sort of plan out your future?
I said it in an interview recently I did with NARC that I purposefully didn't write any new music in lockdown because I didn't want what I wrote to be influenced by it. I wanted to write about things that were normal before lockdown rather than this, because I don't think this will ever be normal to any of us. But when we were briefly allowed to socialise again and places were allowed to open, we practised a few times and we got the newest single we've got coming out literally tomorrow recorded. So yeah, we've been keeping busy and we keep in touch through Zoom and we'll chat in the group and throw ideas at each other. So we can still keep busy. It's just the lack of gigging and the lack of, you know, that feedback you get from people when you play your songs to them to know if it's genuinely good. Because we'll all sit there and think, yeah, this is brilliant, and then we'll play it to somebody and it might fall flat. So we don't have that at the moment. We only have our own feedback, but we can keep them busy enough. It's just obviously waiting to see what happens in the future.
Yes, yeah. I mean, it's all so up in the air at the moment still. So what's your plan? What's your ambition? Are you planning to one day earn a living through your band, or are you happy to engage with it at the level that you're at? And what does music give to you in itself? You know, and what kind of role do you think that it plays in your life?
Well, if I don't make a living from it, which I haven't to this point, because you don't really get too much unless you're on the national level, I wouldn't be bothered as long as I'd made something that I was proud of. Like if we'd made a record that we could look back on in time and go, we made that, that was something we did. And just having the memories with the people I'm making the music with and the shows we play and stuff like that, that's really what we were doing it for. It was never to be commercially successful. It's never something that's really I've ever thought will happen. And it's not because I don't want it to. If it did, I'd be yeah, absolutely, we'd love to do it. But it's not something that I'm actively chasing. It's because I think if you do chase it, then you're open to being sort of swayed by what people want, and it alters your creativity. And I don't think that's the right way to go about it. I'd rather write something that I thought, yeah, I really like that. It reflects what we were thinking at the time and what we wanted to write about around what we thought people would like, which is more often than not just wrong. If you write something you think people will like just because you think they'll like it, they won't. So we've always been like that. Music's just been an escape for me. It's sort of, I find it therapeutic writing because I can get my thoughts out and I can sort of, express my opinions that way. So that's really it, just a sort of escapism. And it's especially important now because there's not much else to be doing.
Yeah, completely. And I think that's a tightrope that so many creative people walk. Obviously, it'd be great to earn a living doing the stuff that you love doing, but does that mean that you've compromised in order to do so? And if so, is it worth it? Is it your creativity anymore?
Yeah, I completely agree. Yeah, I don't think... Only you should ever compromise what you believe in the pursuit of success, because then you'll probably question why you did it in the end eventually anyway.
Yeah, absolutely. I have been asked, because obviously this project's been going now for a few months, and asking people what kind of pathway they see out of lockdown. But I guess with the situation we're in at the moment, it's almost impossible, isn't it? Because we don't even know what to prepare for.
Yeah. I think we'll appreciate the little things more, that maybe we took for granted. I think we'll probably have a greater appreciation for just being able to go and see people and being able to, like, you know, wander in and out of shops without having to, you know, worry about being too close to the next person. Or I think in terms of music, I think it will eventually go back to normal where people can stand and, you know, socialise with each other. But I think there'll just be a greater appreciation for it, because it's made us realise that we probably take some liberties we have for granted.
Yeah, completely. I've only managed to go to one gig since March, which was at Disgraceland. Chaz Thomas played down there. Obviously, there was hardly any of us there, but it was just so fantastic to be out seeing live music. And, you know, there was such an appetite for it that when he got to the end of his set, we all asked him to start again from the top.
Did he?
Yes. Yeah. Well, he played some old songs and he mixed it up a bit. It wasn't exactly the same set, but yeah, he played for just as long again. And that was just absolutely brilliant. It was just an amazing feeling to be out with live music.
Yeah. Nice.
Okay. Well, it's been lovely talking to you. And, you know, hopefully we'll be all out of this soon. So do let me know of any gigs that you actually have coming up. It would be absolutely lovely to get along with you guys.
But, and if any promoters are watching this, feel free to send us some offers and we'll take them.
Absolutely. Send them the money.
Exactly. Thank you very much.
Brilliant. All right. Take care. Hope to see you one day.
Bye-bye.